Hey my friends, a new camera, the GoPro Hero 12 Black, and in today's video we have a look at how to set this camera up for shooting video. If you're interested in my Lightroom presets or LUTs, there's a link down below. Follow it, hopefully you find something that you like. Otherwise, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, follow this channel, and with that, let's jump right into it. After you went through the initial setup and turned on your GoPro for the very first time, these are the easy mode settings that GoPro allows you to do. Standard quality allows you to shoot in 4K, which is probably the best option for most people. In basic quality, 1080p only, you can shoot more video, longer battery life, but it's not as good in terms of quality. And then in the highest quality, 5.3K, best possible video footage, but yeah, less battery life, not as much video, and potentially overkill for most people. In easy mode, the other options that you have is change the field of view, and you can also adjust the framing. We, however, want to have full control over the GoPro, so let's do some tweaking. We go into the settings, tap on preferences, and then tap on video. In here, we can change the bitrate from standard to high, which is now 120 megabits per second, which gives us the best image quality, particularly when shooting in 4K. Next, we change the color from 8-bit to 10-bit. In 10-bit, we have over 1 billion different tones of color, gives us much richer color, less banding, so 10-bit it is. If you're living outside the US, in most cases, you also want to set anti-flicker to 50 Hz. That gets rid of the LED flicker that you see in your video. Now that we tweaked some video settings, we can change the controls from easy to pro, which will give us much more control over the features and the different video settings of our GoPro. Back on the home screen, tap on the video preset button. Here you see all the video presets. You can create new ones. We, however, now want to change the settings. First of all, you can switch between the different profiles, standard, HDR, and log. Let's keep it at standard. It gives us the most options so I can explain them, and then choose the aspect ratio that you want to shoot in. I leave it here at 16:9. It's the standard. The resolution is set to 4K, which in my opinion is the right choice. If you have a reason to shoot in 5.3K, go with that. But in most cases, it's really overkill, so just stick to 4K. When it comes to frame rate, I have the option of 25, 50, and 100 frames per second because I set the anti-flicker to 50 Hz. If you kept it at 60 Hz, you would have the option of 30, 60, and 120 frames per second. I usually choose a frame rate that is twice the frame rate I'm exporting the video in. That gives me some slow motion options, and overall the motion is a bit cleaner and smoother. So for me, it's 50. For others, it may be 60 frames per second. When it comes to lens or field of view, just pick what you like the most. For outdoor activities, I usually go with wide. For regular vlogs, I choose linear because here the GoPro fixes that barrel distortion, so it gives me a more natural look. And if I want to get that extra stability, I go with linear and horizon lock. For now, just let's keep it at wide. Hyper smooth I usually set to on. And now let's have a look at ProTune to dial in the details of our video settings. Shutter speed is usually twice your frame rate. I, however, keep it at auto to give the GoPro a bit of flexibility to adjust the exposure in changing lighting conditions. The GoPro tends to clip the highlights, so EV or exposure value compensation are usually set to minus 0.5 or minus 1. That helps me to preserve the highlights in my image. When shooting in standard, I usually keep the white balance at auto and let the GoPro decide. Otherwise, choose the Kelvin value that makes your image look closest to what the final video should look like. I keep it at auto. Now, ISO determines the sensitivity of the image sensor to light. The higher the ISO, the more sensitive the image sensor, which results in a brighter image, which is really good for low light conditions. However, the more you raise the ISO, the more noise is being introduced to the image. So setting the ISO is always a balancing act between low light capabilities and how much noise you're willing to accept in your image. I prefer a cleaner to a brighter image, so I keep the minimum ISO to 100 and I set the maximum ISO to either 800, sometimes even to 400. Sharpness determines the level of details you capture in your image. Here, when shooting in the standard profile, I feel medium is the right choice. And when it comes to the color profile, you can either go with flat for more neutral colors, or you can choose vibrant for vivid colors and a lot of contrast, but that can be over the top sometimes, or just go with a good compromise, which is natural, which I'm choosing here. The rest of the settings, I leave them as is. Test footage with these settings look great in bright daylight, but when it comes to high contrast scenarios, like for instance here, video of my living room shooting outside the window, there's noise in the shadows, the highlights are overexposed. Here it's better to go with HDR. Almost no noise in the shadows, the highlights, here the clouds, there's much more definition there. What the GoPro does, it shoots essentially two frames, one for the highlights, one for the shadows, and then combines them, which results in a much better image. This means also that the GoPro takes over most of the controls, which means there are very few video settings that you can actually adjust. The aspect ratio is either 16:9 or 8:7 when it comes to the resolution, 4K or 5.3K. And when it comes to frame rate, as I said earlier, the GoPro combines two different frames, which means lower frame rates are available. I go with 25 frames. Under the ProTune settings, you can only adjust the white balance, the sharpness, and then also the color profile. Choose what feels right, as I explained it earlier, but otherwise that's pretty much what you can do when it comes to HDR. HDR can result in great video footage, as you can see here, but there's also the option to shoot in log. Log is a very flat profile that I would only choose if you intend to color grade your footage, which means there's a lot of post-processing involved. But if you color grade it, this would be an example here that you can achieve, which is obviously the best out of the bunch. When shooting in log, again, limited options when it comes to the aspect ratio as well as the resolution. For the frame rate, you have more options again. You can choose up to 100 frames per second. I still stick with 50. And then when it comes to the field of view or the lens, footage that I color grade, I most often shoot in linear because it gives me a more natural look and I want to get a more of a cinematic, you know, feel when color grading the footage. When it comes to ProTune, I don't do much. I set the white balance to native because that gives me a very minimally processed image that is more flexible in color grading in post. Or as an alternative, you could also set the Kelvin value again to something that is closest to what your final video should look like. When shooting in log, you can only set the ISO up to 400. That works for me here, so I just leave it as it is. And since we are color grading our footage any which ways, the sharpness is set to low, so we can dial in the sharpness as needed in post-production. The rest, I just leave it as it is and dial in the image later when I'm color grading the footage. So this is it, my friends. This is how to set up your new GoPro Hero 12 Black for shooting video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up because it helps me and my channel grow. If there's anything that I haven't addressed in today's video, leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. And more importantly, if you want to see more GoPro content, other camera reviews, editing tips, subscribe to this channel so you get notified when I'm uploading new videos. And with that, as always, I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.